So, as you've seen the animation of epicyclic gear train, so let us see how to do that in SOLIDWORKS. So let us start. Go to File, New, click on Assembly. Okay. Now this will open the assembly work environment in front of you. Simply cancel the begin assembly. Go to right plane, sketch on it. So we'll draw simply some circles over here and this way. Okay, we'll give the dimensions to this circle. So give the dimension to it this 160. Okay, give the dimension to this to be 40, and give the dimension to this to be 80. Okay, now what we'll do between these two circle, we'll select these two circle and we'll apply the tangency relation. Okay, we'll select the two points of these circles and we'll apply over here vertical relation. Okay, now we'll select this circle and we'll go to circular sketch pattern. I want four circles like this, so simply do this and say okay. And simply I will exit the sketch over here. Now we'll go to design library where you can find a toolbox. Add in now this toolbox. Go to over here ISO and go down. You will see power transmission gears, and here we will load the spur gear. Now spur gear, you will drag it into assembly environment. So for this gear you can see some data to the left. You can see the module for this gear to be 2, number of teeth on this gear to be 20, pressure angle for this will be 20 degree, face width, so this will be the face width, will be 12 mm. We'll keep the nominal shaft diameter of this to be 20. We'll showing the teeth on it to be 20. So simply say okay. Now this will ask you to load components. So I want three more components like this. So simply click on it and simply cancel the insert component. Now this gear is fixed, so I will make it float. Right, so simply move it away in this way. Now what I will do, I will insert one more spur gear. So here I will keep the number of teeth on this to be 40 number of teeth, and I will make the nominal shaft diameter to be 40 over here. Okay. Now simply cancel this. Now I will again select the design library. This time I will load the internal spur gear over here. Now what I will do, I will increase the number of teeth on this gear to be 18 number of teeth. Okay, and I will make the outside diameter of this gear to be 170. So simply make 170 mm outside diameter and say okay. Now we'll go for some assembly mate over here. So simply go to assembly mate. Simply select this inner face and this circle. Make the concentric mate. Okay. Now what I will do, I will simply select the right plane and the back surface of this gear and simply make coincident mate. Right. Now I will select this inside face and this circle. making the coincident, sorry, concentric made. Simply select this face and this face, making the coincident made. Okay. I will select again the inner face, this circle will make the concentric made. Okay. Simply select this face will make the coincident made. Similarly, do for remaining gears. Concentric, okay. Simply select this face, coincident, okay. Simply select the inner face of this gear and this circle. Make concentric, okay. This fake, make the coincident, okay. Now what we'll do, we'll select this circle and this outer face, make the concentric, okay. We'll select this face and this face, making the coincident mate, okay. So in this way, we have done the assembly mate over here. So simply select this and make it normal too over here. Now what we will do, we'll simply arrange the teeth in a proper way. So we'll simply arrange the teeth in a proper way over here. We'll simply select this gear and arrange the teeth for this gear in a proper way. So this is what exactly these four are, the planetary gears. So we'll arrange the teeth of these four planetary gears, right, in this way. We'll arrange for this, select this and make arrangement for this teeth. Well, now we'll arrange the teeth for the last planetary gear, this. Okay, now we'll arrange the teeth for our sun gear. So this bigger gear is the sun gear, this what I have selected. Now what we will see, whether the teeth are properly meshed or not. So here the teeth are properly meshed, over here also, over here also, and over here also. Now what we'll simply do, we'll go for the gear mate from here. So simply select the mate, go to the mechanical mate and go for the gear mate over here, you can see. Now what we'll do, I will simply select the inner faces of this two gear. So gear ratio is the ratio of number of teeth on this two. So here the number of teeth are 20 and here the number of teeth are 40. So you can see 20-40 over here ratio. So simply say okay. Now select again the gear, select this inner face and this face, again 20-40, okay. Select again the inner gear over here, this face, and select the gear, again 20-40-20, okay. Select again the gear, mate, this face and this face will keep the 20-40 ratio, okay. Now we'll give the mate between the planetary gear and the ring gear. So this internal gear is nothing but the ring gear in case of epicyclic gear train. So simply select the gear, select the inner faces and this outer face. Now here for this number of teeth are 20, but for this the number of teeth will be 80. Right, now we'll make it a reverse. So select reverse over here, automatic, okay. So we have done all the mate. So simply select this and make it normal too. Now we'll hide the sketch over here. So simply right click on it and hide the sketches so that we can see only gears, right. Now what will I do? Simply go to assembly and from here select the move component. So I will simply rotate this planetary gear and see whether other gears are rotating or not. So So you can see, yes, they are rotating, they are properly meshing with each other. Okay, that's it. Now what we'll do, we'll give appearances to this gear. So go to the appearances. Select our ring gear. So for this ring gear, I will give this color. Now we'll select the planetary gear one by one. So for planetary gear, we'll keep the blue color. Sorry, this color. Okay. And again go to appearances. For this, select this and we'll keep the color to be green color. Right? Okay now. Okay. Now we'll go for the motion study over here. So simply select the animation and simply select over here contact. Select all the gear. Drag and select all the gear. Make the contact between them. Say okay. Now we'll select the motor. Simply select the inner face for this. Keep the RPM to be 2. RPM and say okay. And now we'll increase the time over here to some, say 40. Let's say 40. And I will click on the calculate. So here you can see it is starting calculating. So after calculating, you can see a smooth motion for this gear. So it will take some time to calculate. Okay, so here calculation is completed. We'll play back it again. You can see smooth motion. So see here the animation for epicyclic gear train. So there are 4 planetary gears which are rotating about their fixed axes along with the sun gear. So hope you like this animation. Thank you for watching.